Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Well, next Monday is Chinese New Year Day.
下个星期马上就是农历年了。And
as a Chinese, every year, Chinese New Year is always a special time.
身为华人，大年初一都是最特别的日子。The
Chinese race is the largest ethnic group with 1/5 of the world's population.
华人是世界上最多人口的种族，占了五分之一。There
are more people that speak Chinese than any other language in the world.
在世界上说华语的人口超过其他所有的语言。It
is also the most commonly used language already on the internet today.
也是今天网络上面最常使用的一种语言了。
Together with the Jews, Chinese is one of the earliest and the oldest enduring civilizations.
跟犹太人一样，华人也是历史最为悠久的一个文化。
It has a 4,500 years of unbroken history.
整个历史洪流当中，将近经历了4,500年。
But I wonder how many of you have experienced this when we become Christians.
我不晓得有多少人呢，当你做基督徒时候经过这种情况。
You see, to most of us Chinese, when we become Christians, somehow we are made to feel like we have forsaken our Chinese roots.
我们中国人做了基督徒之后，好像让我们感觉到我们放弃自己华人的根了。
That we have abandoned our Chinese heritage and culture.
放弃自己的文化，我们遗产传来的产业。
That we have embraced a foreign Western religion, a religion of the white people.
现在去拥抱是西方外来的文化，是西方白种人的宗教。
And so we kind of feel a little embarrassed.
我们感觉好有点不好意思了。
Especially during Chinese New Year season.
特别在过农历年的时候。
You meet your family and relatives and say, "Oh, we hear that now you're a Christian."
听到你的朋友、亲戚、家人说：“哎呦，听说你现在做基督徒了。”
You no longer love your family.
哦，不爱你家人了哈。
You no longer love your parents anymore, huh?
你再不再爱你爸爸妈妈了。
Oh, they will say, "Well, you know, now you jiak kang dang, is it? Huh?
You eat potato." 哇，现在jiak kang dang，哇，已经不一样了。
Because if you're Chinese, you should either be a Taoist, a Confucianist, or a Buddhist.
因为如果你是华人，你要就是道教徒，要不然佛教徒，要不然儒教徒了。
Now I want to say this: that those are great religions.
我要告诉你，那些都是很好的宗教。There
are many, many millions of believers and followers of Buddhism, Taoism, and Confucianism.
在今天世界上有上百万追随着道教、儒教、佛教的信徒。But
today I want to give you a little bit of education.
可是今天呢，要给大家一些教育。Tell
your neighbor and say you're going to enjoy the word.
跟旁边人享受神的话语。The
Chinese history has a 4,500 year unbroken record.
整个中华的历史将近有4,500年不断延续下来。Let's
take this to be 0 BC.
把这个当作公元初年。So
now we are here. We are at 2009.
现在我们在2009年这里.
Year of the ox.
牛年.
If this is a youth service, I'll say, turn to your neighbor and moo. All right, anyway.
不可以跟旁边的moo啊.
Moo, okay. But you know what? The Chinese history stretches until 2500 BC.
华人的历史可以一直往前推到主前2500多年。
Now, Taoism came about 6 BC.
道教大概是公元前6世纪来的。
About the 5th BC, you have Confucianism, and you have, I spelled wrongly, Buddhism.
而大概在公元第5世纪的时候，有儒家跟佛教出现。
So the big question is, what about those 2,000 years?
问题就在这中间2000多年呢?
Before Taoism, Confucianism, and Buddhism, what did the Chinese people believe in?
在道教、儒家、佛教出现之前，华人相信的是什么?
What is interesting is this, we have very clear historical records.
很有意思的，我们有非常清楚的历史记录在。
For the first 2,000 years of their history, the Chinese people worshipped a singular supreme God and not many dozens or millions of deities.
在这2000多年当中，华人一直在敬拜的是一位独一的最高主权的真神，而不是许许多多的神明。
They worship a God by the name of 上帝。
他们敬拜的这位叫上帝的神。
Today I'm going to write in my broken Chinese.
今天我要来练习我的中文字。
All right. Now, and this When you read the historical records,
当你读到整个历史记录里头，
上帝 has exactly the same character, nature, and power as the God of the Old Testament.
实际上，这位上帝跟我们旧约相信的神有同样的品格、同样的性情、同样的能力。
But while the Hebrew people called him Yahweh or Jehovah,
虽然犹太人把他称为耶和华或亚卫。
The Chinese people from the beginning call him 上帝 the King that lives above the Most High God.
华人却把这位神称之为上帝，是一位君王，在万物之上，居在天上的。
Some of them call him as 天 or as 上天。
也有人把他直接称之为天了。
Now you notice how you write the word 天。
你注意天怎么写？
Everything that is big, that is star, he's bigger than them. He's the most high.
在天下至大至上最高的那个就是至高神。
So the Old Testament calls him the most high God.
所以旧约里面称他为至高神。
Let's give the most high God a big clap. Hallelujah.
为他热烈的拍掌。Hallelujah.
China's greatest historian was a man by the name of Sima Qian.
在中国当中有一个非常了不起的史学家叫司马迁。
In his classic historical records, he recorded of a king called 皇帝 or the Yellow Emperor.
而在他流传千古的著作《史记》当中，记载了第一个人叫皇帝。
Now, 皇帝 is supposed to be the originator of all Han people, Han Chinese.
皇帝基本上是所有汉族人的始祖。
He lived around 2400 BC to 2500 BC. That means right from the beginning.
他所居住的时代大概是公元前2400到2500年，在最开头的时候。
And Sima Qian recorded that 皇帝 actually built an altar in Taishan, which is the mountain in Shantung Province, to worship 上帝 God, the one supreme God.
司马迁记载，皇帝特别到了中国山东的泰山，在那里为上帝这位神筑了一座坛，崇拜他。
Sima Qian also recorded in his historical records a comment by a Han Dynasty scholar.
而司马迁在史记当中同时也记载汉代另外一位史学家的记录。
Well, the Chinese, I'm going to ask Lu to read what was written.
这位史学家郑玄他写的中文是说，上帝者天之别名也，神无二主。
In other words, 上帝 is another name for 天。
上帝就是天的另外一个名字。
And he says,he says this, the spirits do not have two lords. In other words, the Lord your God is one.
他讲得很清楚，只有独一真神，没有两个主。
Again, it confirms exactly what the Old Testament says.
再一次又印证我们旧约所教导的。
Now, there is also a song found in the collected statues of the Ming Dynasty.
另外在大明会典当中有一首收集到的当时的歌谣。
I am not even going to attempt to try to read the 文言文。
哇，读这个文言文大概会昏倒的。
But Lulu is able to do it, so let's.
Lulu 可以为大家念出来。这边这个歌谣他说：鱼袭洪荒之初兮，魂蒙五行未雨兮，两曜未明，其中挺立兮，有无容身？神皇初遇兮，始判浊清，立天立地人兮。群物生生。
Now let me translate it for you.
这个要为大家解释一下了。
Of the old in the beginning, there was a great chaos without form and dark.
在创造之初，一切是混沌灰暗的。
The five planets have not begun to revolve, nor the two lights to shine.
五颗行星尚未运转，那两个光体也未照亮。
In the midst of it, there existed neither form nor sound.
在这当中，既无声响，也无形体。
You, O spiritual sovereign, came forth in your sovereignty and first did separate the impure from the pure.
而主权之神啊，唯有你出来判断所有清浊之分。
Now notice the order. You make heaven, you make earth, you make man. All things became alive with reproducing power.
注意它的顺序哦。你立了天，立了地，创造人，使这一切万物生生不息。
Turn your Bible with me to Genesis chapter 1 and verse 1.
跟我一起翻开《创世纪》第一章第一节。
Doesn't this commentary sound exactly like the book of Genesis?
哎，这里是不是就像为《创世纪》写了注释一样？
It says in verse 1, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth.
第一节说起初神创造天地。
The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep.
地是空虚混沌，渊面黑暗。
And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters.
神的灵运行在水面上。
And then it says God separated light from darkness, and the land from the waters.
之后神将光与暗分开，水与地分开。
And he created trees and plants.
他创造了树木、采书。
Fish and birds and beasts of the field. And then he created man.
有鱼、有鸟、田间的野兽。之后他创造人。
And Genesis 1 says, all were given reproducing power to produce after their own kind.
而创世纪告诉我们，每一个都有生育的能力，照他们各从其类的生产。
Can you see, long before all this worship came in,
你看到早在这些拜偶像的事情之前，
long before Taoism, Confucianism, and Buddhism,
早在这些道教、儒教、佛教之前，
before there were temples that were full of idols for you to worship,
在那些有很多庙宇、那些偶像拜敬之前，
for 2,000 over years, the Chinese people worship a singular supreme sovereign God who is the creator of heaven and earth, and his name is 上帝。
中国人在两千多年一直在敬拜是一位独一有至高主权的神，他的名叫上帝。
Who has the same nature, character, and power of Jehovah Yahweh God of the Old Testament.
而他的本性、品格与能力跟我们旧约的亚威上帝是一样的。
Now, nobody knows when Chinese writing was originated.
没有人知道中文的文字起源在哪里。
But most will agree, Chinese writing came about probably in 2500 BC.
可是大部分人都同意，大概公元前2500年就有了中国的文字了。
So centuries before the Egyptians built the pyramids, you have the Chinese writing.
所以在埃及人还没盖金字塔好几个世纪之前，中国人就开始写字了。
And with Chinese writing, with the ability to write, that means you can document history.
在中国人能够有文字写下来，代表你可以记载历史了。
Now this is very interesting.
这就很有意思啦。
Because from the time they were able to document history,There were several global events that everybody could remember.
在他们能够有能力记载历史的时候，有一些全球性的事件是大家通通记得的。
During the same time as 2500 BC,
就大概在公元前2500年那样的时代里，
you have the flood.
在这之前有洪水。
You have the Tower of Babel.
在那时候有巴别塔。
Now, what other events?Were there the people possibly, if they were alive and if those events were true, they could remember?
而在那个时代还活着的人，还有什么样的事情是人家永远不会忘记的呢？
Now, I mean, wouldn't you agree, if there's a flood that covers the whole earth, then you definitely you will remember.
如果一个全世界的大洪水，你大概一定都会记得吧？
If there is a Tower of Babel that caused people to be scattered everywhere and languages to come forth, surely you remember.
如果巴别塔使得人们四散到各处，语言变乱了，你一定会记得啊。
Now, if those events were true,
如果这些事件是真实的，
and that the Bible is not a fable,
圣经不是随便的神话故事，
then the people that are alive around 2500 BC, they must remember the creation story.
那在公元2500年的人，他们也不会忘记创造的故事。
Because Adam was alive 1,600 years before.
因为在1600年前，亚当还活在世上呢。
You see, when the flood came, you know, Methuselah, just died.
你要了解，是在马土撒拉刚死的时候，洪水降临。
And when Methuselah was alive, Adam was also alive.
当马土撒拉在世的时候，亚当也还活在世上哦。
In those days, the people lived a long time.
那个年代的人活得很长寿的。
Adam lived 900 years.
亚当活了九百多年。
Methuselah 969 years.
马土撒拉活了九百六十九年。
In fact, it was only 8 generations from creation to the flood.
实际上从创造到洪水才八个世代而已。
So if these things were true,
如果这些都是真实的，
then people alive must surely remember them.
当时存活的人也一定记得他才对啊。
And surely they want to document downIn their historical records.
也想在他们的历史当中记载下这一切。
Now, Chinese writings are unique because somehow they have this ability to capture Chinese history.
华文的文字之所以特别，是它可以有这个能力记载历史的。
Because they don't use letters, they use characters in picture form.
因为华文不是用字母拼组在一起，而是用形态显示出来的。
So every Chinese word not only expresses a meaning, it captures a history.
因此每一个华文字不但是表达语意思，还能够带出历史来。
Every character tells a story.
每一个文字可以讲一篇故事。
So if all these things had happened,
如果这一切都曾经发生过，
And that the Chinese people were the descendants of the Tower of Babel.
而华人也是在巴别塔之后散出来的百姓。
They were the descendants of Noah.
他们是挪亚的后裔的话。
Surely they want to record all these global cataclysmic events.
当然他们要记载下这种全球灾难性的事件在。
And for the next 20 minutes or so, I'm going to show you that all these global events were documented in Chinese history.
接下来20分钟，我让你看见所有全球事件都记载在华文历史里面。
Come on, let's give the Lord a big hand.
为主热烈的拍掌。
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All right.Go with me to Genesis 1 and verse 26. Let's start there.
创世纪章十六节这里开始。
It says, Genesis 1:26.
创世纪章十六节。
Then God said, "Let us make man in our image."
神说，让我们照我们的形象造人。
The word "make" also means to create.
这个造就是创造的造。
Create in Chinese is the word 造。
中文的造就是这个创造的造字。
Now notice how you write this word.
注意到这个字怎么写啊
？All right, this word is written this way.
这个字的写法是这样子。
There was speaking words.
首先有说话的告。
And as words were spoken, movement happens.
当这宣告说出，就有行动产生了。
So 走字旁 over words.
所以在这个告旁边是一个走字边。
And isn't it true when God spoke the word, living thing began to move?
不是这样吗？神一说话就开始活物出来了。
So right from the word create, you know that the creation story was recorded there.
从第一个创造的造字，你就看见创造的故事在里面。
And look at verse 22.
你看二十二节这里。
And God blessed them and saying, "Be fruitful and multiply."
神就赐福给他们，让他们生养众多。
Now we all Chinese, we love this word bless.
所有华人都很爱这个字福。
Chinese New Year, we see this everywhere.
农历年到处都看到这个字儿。
You know, and sometimes we have this word pasted on our doors and our businesses because this word means good fortune.
不管是家门口、公司门口都贴这个字，为什么？福气就是好运呢、啊、
？Yeah, and we want good fortune to come to our families and come to our workplace.
希望福气好运能够到我们的家里面、到公司里来。
And sometimes we turn it upside down.
有的时候故意倒着贴这个字儿。
That means the blessings to flow.
代表这个福到了。
But what is prosperity in its original meaning to the Chinese?
可是对华人来说，福原本的意思是什么？
How do you write 福？
福这个字怎么写的？
Now watch, it is 神字旁, it is God.
你看到旁边这个士字旁是神的意思。
Together at one with a mouth.
有一口代表一个人的单位。
So God together with a soul, one mouth.
代表神跟一个人一个灵魂在一起。
In a garden.
在田园里
So that is prosperity.
这叫福分、哎、
Prosperity to ancient Chinese is not just material wealth and money.
对古代华人来说，福分不光是金钱物质而已。
But it's for God and man to have a one relationship in a fruitful garden, in your fruitful family or in your workplace.
是神跟人有美好的关系，在美好的园子、你的公司、你的家庭、的职场里面。
Oh, come on, you want to clap? Give the Lord a big clap.
我就热烈的拍掌。
Turn to your neighbor and say, God wants to have a good relationship with you.
跟旁边说，神要跟你有美好的关系。
He wants to prosper you.
他要赐福于你。
Amen. Now look at Genesis 2 and verse 15.
你看到创世纪第二章十五节这里。
It says in verse 15, Then the Lord took the man and put him in the garden of Eden to tend and to keep it.
十五节，耶和华神将那人安置在伊甸园，使他修理看守。
Now how do you write the word garden in Chinese?
中文园这个字怎么写呢
Look at the screen, is this word 园 Everybody say 园
园
Now notice, watch everybody
每一个人仔细看啊
God took clay to
神拿了尘土起来
He breathed with his mouth
用口吹气进去
On two people, one is a man 人
两个人身上一个是一个人、啊、男人
Out of his side came forth a woman
从他身旁出来了女人
And put them in a garden
把他们放在这个范围里。
That's how you got the word garden.
这就是园啦。
Derek is getting excited, although he's not Chinese.
Derek 不是中国人都开始兴奋了。
Genesis 2 verse 16.
在二章十六节这里。
And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, "Of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but the tree of knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you eat of it you shall surely die."
耶和华神吩咐他说，园中各样树上的果子你可以随意吃，只是分别善恶树上的果子你不可吃，因为你吃的日子必定死。
So God stopped them，
神拦阻他们，
prohibited them，
禁止他们。
Now to forbid in Chinese is this word 禁，
在中文里面讲禁止的禁字。
Now how do you write the word 禁？ Now look， God gave them， God put them in a garden， you have trees，
神给他们放在园子里面，有这个树林在。
He gave them a revelation， 启示，
还把启示告诉他们这个柿子。
是 ，God gave them revelation about the tree。
神给他们这树木的启示。
Don't you eat it？
不要吃哦。
If you eat it, you will die。
你吃的话必定死。
Why were there two trees？
为什么放两棵树呢
？Because there was a tree of life and a tree of knowledge of good and evil。
因为有生命之树，还有分别善恶之树。
All right, now, well。Genesis chapter 3 verse 1 now.
现在到第三章第一节这里了。
Here came the problem.
这里有问题了。
Now the serpent was more cunning than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made.
耶和华神所造的唯有蛇比田野一切的活物更狡
猾。So the devil came to tempt the woman.
魔鬼来试探女人了。
Now, what is the word tempter in Chinese? The person who gives temptation.
中文试探诱惑人让人入魔的那个魔字怎么写
？Is this word? Look，
你看呢
？Everybody said 魔。
魔。
Now how do you write the word 魔？
魔这个字怎么写呢
？All right， there was a garden。
这边有个园子。
And then there was a movement。
哇，有一个行动一撇在那儿。
One guy came to man， 儿。
他来找人了，那个人儿子。
Secretly。
私下的。
This is the word.
私,
私 means secret.
这个私就是秘密的意思。
So this word, 鬼 means devil.
这个就是魔鬼那个鬼字了。
Also, it means suspicious. 鬼鬼祟祟。
中文也讲鬼鬼祟祟的。
He came in.
他进来。
Slow movement.
慢动作。
Where did he come?
他到哪儿去？
He came to the among the trees.
他是在树林当中来的。
Undercover.
在林荫之下。
He came as a tempter.
他来引诱人了。
So he tried to seduce Eve.
他来诱惑夏娃。
Eve eat the fruit.
夏娃吃着果子。
Eve, the Bible says, lusted after the fruit, got greedy for it.
圣经说夏娃就贪婪看着这果子。
How do you write the word to lust or to 贪婪的婪？
这个贪婪的婪字怎么写的呢
？Notice.Is again those three over a woman.
注意到这两棵树在这个女人之上哦。
Because the woman fell into sin first.
因为第一次出现贪婪，就是女人掉入罪中。
All right, now temptation is always tough.
试探都是很难搞的。
So what is the Chinese word for difficulty or worry, your stress?
因此，当中文讲到困难、困惑的时候，这个困字怎么写
？Isn't it this word 木？Over a boundary.
是不是把个木圈在这个框框里头呢
？You don't touch this tree.
不要碰这棵树啊
！Oh, very difficult, 很辛苦啊，
很困难啊！
我要，我要。Well, sin, Eve fell into sin, and then Adam too.
夏娃、亚当他们掉到罪里面了。
And the result of the temptation was sin or 罪。
试探带下的结果就是这个罪字。
Now, the ancient form of 罪, I'm going to write for you, the ancient form.
你要了解罪的古字不是长这样。
All right, I'm now an expert in ancient Chinese.
我现在是古文的专家了。
Okay.
看起来很古的样子哈。
Now, this one, sin, this 罪, the ancient form.
这是中国古文的罪字。
It's actually a man, 人, with his nose.
It's the nose of a man. 上头啊。是自我的字，是人的鼻子。
And he feels very bitter, very 辛苦。
而下面是一个辛苦的辛字。
So this was the original meaning of the word 罪。
这是罪原来的样子哦。
But when 秦始皇 came along, he united China in 221 BC.
可是大概在2100多年时候，秦始皇出现，整合整个中国。
This is the man that built the Great Wall of China.
就这个人建了中国的长城。
And he changed this word.
他把这个字给改了。
From this word, he changed it to this, for, against.
他把这个字改成四 个非这个罪字。
You see, this is the word for, and this is the word against.
所以你看见上面是个四，下头是个非。
Now, 秦始皇 was not a Christian.
秦始皇不是基督徒哦。
But by the way, not every emperor was a non-believer. There were many emperors who were believers of God.
可是要先澄清啊，不是每一个皇帝都是不信主的，好些皇帝是认识耶稣的。
I'm gonna talk about it more.
这个呢，我会更多的讲到。
But although 秦始皇 was not a Christian, but he was moved by God.
虽然秦始皇不是基督徒，但神同样可以感动他。
Why was the 罪 written as for against?
为什么
for opposition?
是四个非放在一块儿
的 Or four contradictions.
四个似是而非
Because do you know there were four contradictions here in Genesis chapter 3?
因为在创世第三章就有四个似是而非之处
Look at verse 1.
你看第一节
The devil says, Has God indeed said you shall not eat of every tree of the garden?
魔鬼说神岂是真说你们不可吃园中树上所有的果子吗
Now this is not true.
不是这样啊
It was against the word of God.
这跟神的话是似是而非的
Because God said,You cannot eat of only one tree.
神说只有一棵树的果子不可以吃。
You can eat every tree except one.
所有树可以吃，只有这棵不可以。
First contradiction.
这是第一个似是而非。
Second contradiction, verse 2.
第二个似是而非的第二节。
Now Eve got sucked in.
现在夏娃也被吸进来了。
She said, God has said, you shall not eat it, nor shall you touch it, lest you die. Again, not true.
神曾说你们不可吃也不可摸免得你们死哎，又不对了
God allowed them to touch it just don't eat it
神可以让他们摸但不可以吃而已
Second contradiction
第二个似是而非
Third contradiction verse 4
第三个似是而非第四节了
The serpent said to the woman You will not surely die That's not true
神对女人说你们不一定死不对呀
God said you eat it You will die That's the third contradiction
神说吃的那日必定死这是第三个似是而非了
Fourth contradiction, verse 5.
而第四个似是而非第五节。
For God knows that in the day you eat of it, your eyes will be open, and you will be like God.
因为神知道你们吃的日子眼睛明亮，便如神一样了。
So the devil was trying to tell Eve, well, God is not wanting you to be so powerful like him, so he's stopping you from eating. That's the fourth contradiction.
魔鬼告诉夏娃是神不希望你跟他一样有能力，所以他们不让你吃。这是第四个似是而非了。
So the first time this word 罪 came out.
第一次有这个罪的形状出来的时候
It was depicting Genesis chapter 3 of the four contradictions that led to the first sin.
哇这就描绘出创世第三章那四个带出人罪恶的似是而非。
Oh, come on, let's give the Lord a big hand. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Look at verse 7 right now.
你看到第七节。
And the eyes of both of them were open and they knew they were naked.
他们两人眼睛就明亮知道自己赤身露体。
Now, how do you write the word naked?
这个赤裸的裸怎么写
Look at the screen now.
你看到荧幕上的
Notice it got to do with, now watch, it got to do with your clothing, 一字旁
注意到跟你穿的衣服有关呢
Your covering is gone when you eat of the 果子 the fruit.
当你吃那个果子这个衣服就不见了
So the first time naked came in, it got to do with covering gone because of a fruit, Genesis.
第一次感到赤裸就创世纪里面教的你吃了果子就开始遮蔽自己
Now look at verse 8.
你看第八节
And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God from the trees of the garden.
天起了凉风，耶和华神在园中行走，那人和他妻子听见神的声音，就藏在园里的树木中躲避耶和华神的面。
Now Adam went into hiding.
亚当去躲起来了。
How do you write this word hide?
躲这个字怎么写的呢
？Now his body, 身体，
他的身子
，nai is.
奶
superimposed to the tree
藏在木头后头了
So his body is the tree
他的身子就好像树木一样了
In other words, you can't see him He's hiding behind the tree
换句话躲在树木后头你看不到他了
Man was in hiding Why? He felt the guilt and shame of sin
人躲起来为什么因为他感受到罪的那个羞愧
How do you write guilt?
这个愧字怎么写呢
Well, look at the screen
你看荧幕上头
Look, it isIt got to do with heart, 心字旁 your heart.
跟你的心有关嘛，所以心字旁。
And the devil got into your heart.
啊，鬼进到心里去了。
你心里有鬼啊。
有鬼啦。
Now, what happened?
怎么回事
The devil got into foothold of man's life.
魔鬼在人的生命中站了脚步了。
Well, with the fall of man, sin becomes a part of human nature.
因为人堕落， 罪成为人性的一部分了。
So by the time they come to Genesis chapter 4, the first crime ever committed was recorded.
到了创世纪第四章，就记载下人类的第一次犯罪。
It has to do with two brothers.
这跟两兄弟有关呢。
Who are the two brothers? Cain and Abel.
哪两兄弟？就是该隐跟亚伯。
So what happened?
怎么回事？
Well, Cain killed Abel.
这个哥哥做兄长的该隐杀了弟弟亚伯。
All right. So, 兄弟成为凶手。The brother become murderer.
所以他的兄长成了凶手了。
How do you write murder?
凶手的凶怎么写呢？
Notice it looks almost the same.
哇，长得很像哎，这两个。
And look at Genesis 4 verse 15.
你看到四章十五节那里说的。
Cain pled for mercy.
该隐跟神求怜悯。
God, please, you know, please, if you banish me right now, everybody's gonna attack me.
神啊，你把我赶出去，每一个人都可以攻击我了。
God said, all right, I'm gonna have a special protection over you.
神说好，我在你身上有特别的保护。
But you'll be marked for life.
可是你一生都带着这个记号。
So look at Genesis 4 and verse 15.
你看到四章十五节这里。
And the Lord set a mark on Cain, lest anyone find him should kill him.
耶和华给该隐立一个记号，免得人遇见就杀他。
How do you write the word 凶 or murder?
这个凶恶的凶字怎么写？
It is a man's head or face, and it was marked.
一个人的额头上面做了个记号。
You see, that is murder.
看到没？凶恶的凶字。
Mark on Cain's head.
就印在该隐的头上的。
Right in ancient times, all the story of creation was recorded in their writings.
所以早在古代，所有创造的故事都记在我们的文字里了。
Now we come to the flood in Genesis chapter 7.
来到创世第七章，我们看见洪水的事发生。
Look at Genesis chapter 7, verse 7.
你看到第七章第七节这里。
So Noah with his sons, his wife, and his sons' wives went into the ark because of the waters of the flood.
挪亚同他的妻和儿子儿妇都进入方舟，躲避洪水。
What is the Chinese word for a big boat?
中文要写船这个字怎么写的？
船。Everybody say 船。
船。
Right. How many of you have written this as a Chinese in primary school? Put up your hands.
有多少人小学学过这个船字的举手？
You see, you're writing this, but you're writing Genesis story and you don't even know.
哇，你每次来写创世纪的故事，你自个儿都不知道嘞。
How do you write 船？ Look, 写这里。
船这个字怎么写的？你看啊。
A 舟 a boat.
啊，这就是一艘船，舟。
With 8 people, 八。
里面有八口人。
You say, why 8 people in the boat?
诶，怎么船上有八个人啊？
Because chapter 7 and verse 7 says,Noah and his wife, two people.
在创世纪七章七节说，挪亚跟他太太两个人了。
Three sons, that makes it five.
三个儿子，五个了。
And three daughter-in-laws, that's eight.
再加三个媳妇，多少？八个人。
The first time boat was used, eight people were inside.
第一次用船的时候，里头就是八个人的。
Recorded in Chinese history.
华人的文字里面就记下来了。
Oh, come on, let's give the Lord another big clap. Hallelujah.
再次拍一掌 ，Hallelujah.
Now we come to the Tower of Babel.
现在又看到巴别塔了。
All right, this is the third big major global event.
这是第三个全球重大的事件。
Like 9/11 has to do with a tower.
好像九一一样，它跟高塔有关的。
But not because a plane hit the tower.
可是不是飞机飞进去的关系啊。
So we come to Genesis 11.
你看到创世纪十一章。
And here the world got wicked again.
这里世界再一次掉入邪恶里。
Look at Genesis 11 and verse 1.
十一章一节这里说。
Now the whole earth had one language and one speech.
那是天下人的口音言语都是一样。
All right, and verse 4, they say, Come, let us build ourselves a city and a tower whose top is in the heavens. Let us make a name for ourselves, lest we be scattered abroad over the face of the whole earth.
第四节他们说，来吧，我们要建造一座城和一座塔，塔顶通天，为要传扬我们的名，免得我们分散在全地上。
Now, how do you write the word tower in Chinese?
而中文的这个塔字是怎么写的呢？
It's the word 塔, everybody say 塔。
塔。
Right? Now, notice how you write it.
注意这个字怎么写。
All the people, 人。
首先全部都是人。
Speaking one,
还一。
Mouth or one language.
口同声的。
People have one speech. This is the Chinese word. 和。
人众口一声的是什么？合一的合字。
So when we have one vision, one language, we speak one one word, we are united together.
当我们有同样的意象，当我们说同样的语言，我们就是合一在一起的。
But here they were united for something evil.
可是这里的合一是为邪恶的事情。
They were taking grass, 草字头。
拿了草出来，所以有草字头。
And clay, 土字边。
加上土字边的土一起。
And they formed the word 塔。
就形成这个塔字。
So the first time tower is used in Chinese history, it got to do with people in unity together building something.
而人第一次使用塔这个字，就是人们合一在一起要建造一个东西。
Now, look at verse 9.
你看第九节。
Therefore, its name is called Babel, because there the Lord confused the language of all the earth.
因为耶和华在那里变乱天下人的语言，因此那城名叫巴别。
Now, what did you say in Chinese?
中文怎么说的？变乱。
变乱。Confusion or 乱, how do you write it?
这个混乱的乱字怎么写呢？
It got to do with your tongue.
这跟你的舌头有关啊。
This is the word 舌头 or tongue.
这是舌头的舌字。
And because of tongue, now this...Word, this character, it is the right leg. It's your right leg.
这个边旁呢，就像人的右腿一样。
It speaks of the right leg scattering in one direction.
代表是从一个方向用这个右腿把它快散。
Confusion,
混乱。
Because of the words, the people were scattering.
因为这些人的言语的关系被赶散出去了。
Because the language was being mixed up.
他们的言语被变乱了。
Now the Chinese word for scattering is the word 分散。
中文讲到分散这两个字，
分散，
你看到分散这两个字。
The pronunciation is not so good. I got to learn from Lulu. How do you write the word 分散？
分散这两个字要怎么写呢？
Can you see here? Can you see here?
下面看得到吗？
Everybody turn your neighbor and say, look, look at pastor. Come on.
跟旁边说要看着牧师啊。
Okay. All right. It is the word 巴 and the word 刀 a knife.
这个分字上头是一个八字，下头是一把刀。
Why is that eight?
为什么写个八呢？
Because there were eight generations leading to the Tower of Babel.
因为从八个世代才数到巴别塔这里来。
And they were all divided by the knife, so there was division.
因此又把刀把他们分开来，让他们分隔出去。
Now 分散散
散
散散分散
散。
My Hanyu pinyin is not so good. 分散。Now look, 分散 is all the people. This is where you get the word 共。
这个呢是共有的共上头那个字。
人民共和国共 right?
Yeah, 那个共字。
And this is 肉字边 flesh.
下头是个肉字边，所有有血气的。
And this word, Lulu, help me.
这个是扑字旁。
扑字旁 that means followed.
这个是从后跟上的意思。
So look, put them all together.
把他们全部放在一块。
Generations were divided, and all the flesh followed.
这世代被分隔，所有有血气的跟随而去。
So because of the Tower of Babel.
因为有巴别塔
all the people were scattered.
所有人被赶散出去
and one major group went in towards the east and settled in the land of China.
很重要的一组人往东边去，到了中国安定下来
So they migrated.
因此他们迁移过去了
Okay, the word migrated or scattered is this word. Look.
而中文迁移的这个迁字你看到了
Now, very interesting.
很有意思啊。
Okay, this is the last space I have. Okay, so everybody look at this last space.
每个人看到最后一个洞了啊。
All right. Now, how do you write this word 迁?
这个迁字要怎么写呢?
It was a big migration. 大。
这是一个很大的迁移，所以有个大字。
大。And this word, 四。
这个四字。
Which means division.
这个字是分散的意思。
So there was a big division.
一个很大的分散。
Where did it happen from?
从哪儿发生的呢
？From the west，
是在西边发生的。
So Babel to the Chinese race is known as the west。
对华人来说，巴别塔是在西边的事情。
Remember, we all have the, you know, the Chinese mythological story of the monkey god. He went to the west。
中国那个很好玩的童话故事叫《西游记》。
All right, where is the west to them? It's not America. It's not England. It is Tibet. It's towards that area.
他们的西方在哪儿？不是美国、英国，是到西藏、印度那儿去。
So Babel to them at that time is the West.
对他们来说，巴别塔就是西边了。
Big division at the West, and as a result, people were scattered against 走字旁。
因为西边这个大型的分散，使得人们要走了。
So they all scattered and settled in the land of China.
因为这样的分散，让他们安定到中国之地。
皇帝 was one of the descendants.
皇帝是他们当一个始祖。
And in his time, the Chinese character was invented.
在那个时候，中国的文字开始发明出来了。
And all these things was recorded.
这一切都记载下来。
But they didn't just record history.
可是他不光记历史而已。
Remember, 皇帝 worshiped 上帝。
记得吗？皇帝特别去拜上帝。
So there was this concept.
有这样的概念。
That God did not want to forsake relationship with man, although we have fallen into sin.
尽管我们掉入最终，神没有撇弃跟人的关系。
How many of you know God doesn't want to give up His relationship with us? Amen.
多少人知道神一直要跟我们建立关系的？
So what did God do?
神要做什么呢？
Well, the Old Testament tells you He instituted a system of blood sacrifice.
而旧约告诉我们，他设立整个世界上血祭的系统。
All right, now how do you write the word sacrifice?
这个牺牲献祭的牺字怎么写？
Just a few more, okay? Then I'm done.
再几个字就写完了哈。
All right, yeah. How you write sacrifice?
这个牺牲的牺字怎么写？
Look, sacrifice.
你看这个字啊。
You say, ah, pastor, very hard.
牧师，这个字很难呢。
Okay, let me see. Well, what did God do? The book of Hebrews tells us.
神是怎么做的？希伯来书告诉我们。
Leviticus tells us.
利未记也说了。
God says, take the cow.
神说把你们牛带来。
Take the lamb.
把你们的羊带来。
But it got to be without blemish.
可是是最美没有残疾的。
Sure. Perfect.
是完美的。
Kill them with a spear, 哥。
用刀割把它给杀了。
Offer as a sacrifice.
把它献上为祭。
Can you see the whole concept of the blood sacrifice is already in this one word?
你看见一个字里面把整个献祭的概念放在里头了。
Especially use the sacrifice.Of a baby lamb.
特别要献上是羊羔的祭。
So how you write a 羊羔 or 羔羊？
这个羔字怎么写呢？
You take a lamb, put it through fire.
你把羊放在火上头。
So the concept is take a lamb, sacrifice it, burn it.
所以概念就是把羊带来，牺牲它，烧了它。
Then what do you do? Take the blood.
你还要做什么？你还要盛他的血。
Do you know the original Chinese word for blood is this picture of a vessel with a drop of blood inside?
你知道中国古字的血字是长这个样，一个器皿里头一个点。
This is the vessel of a cup, a Chinese cup with blood inside.
这是一个中国杯子的形状，里面放的是血。
But then it was changed.
可是后来改了这个字呢？
It was changed to this word, 血。
慢慢演化成今天我们所写这个血字。
Now, how do you write 血？
这个血怎么写的？
血 is actually, now watch, it is blood, a dash of blood, in a vessel, min, this is the word, this is vessel.
你把一滴血放在器皿的皿里头。
Now, you say, this is too hard. No, you're singing this all the time in the Chinese church.
你说，哎呦，这个很难嘞。没有没有，我们华文教会一天到晚唱的嘞。
Since when?
什么时候有唱啊？
Well, remember the song Above All Else?
你记得我们唱那首歌 Above All Else 吗？
You know, Ellie comes every week.
Ellie 每个礼拜来啊。
So imagine I'm Ellie right now, long hair.
假设我现在是长头发的 Ellie 啊。
You know, I... Tall.
高挑窈窕的身材。
Always sing like this, Ellie.
每次唱歌都是这样的。
Here I stand, 相扶于你。Here I stand, 渴慕于你。愿成为你器皿。Every week you're singing it.
每个礼拜你在唱嘞。
The whole concept of blood in a vessel.
整个血盛在器皿里的概念。
Bring before the presence of God.
要带到神的面前。
For the forgiveness of our sin.
来赦免我们的罪。
All right. Ultimately, Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God, sent by the Lord, sent by God Himself.To be the savior of the world. Hallelujah.
而最终，耶稣基督，神的羔羊，是神亲自拆下来，成为我们的献祭。
Come on, give the Lord a big clap.
那就热烈的拍掌。
And you know, this he came to give us righteousness.
他来是要赐公义给我们。
And righteousness is this word, lamb over me.
而义这个字就是羊在我之上。
Lamb.
羊
over me,
在我之上。
So notice sacrifice always got to do with lamb.
注意到牺牲一直跟羊有关呢。
Now, remember many people say, and you heard it before, what about, you know, you guys are Christians. You know, you say God loves the world, but what about ancient China?
很多人在说，哎呀，你们今天到底说神爱中国，这个可是你看古代中国人怎么办？
What about all this ancient China?
那些古代的中国人呢？
I got so fed up of people talking to me like this.
每次人家这样跟我讲，我都受不了了。
The next time somebody talk to you, especially during this Chinese New Year, you tell them this, what I'm going to tell you right now.
下次有人这样问你，特别农历年的时候，你就把我现在要跟你讲的告诉他们啊。
This word, thousands of years old.
这个字已经几千年的历史了。
Longer before Jesus even came.
早在耶稣第一次降临之前就有了。
How do you write this word?
这个字怎么写的？
Originally, you take a lamb.
一开头你拿一只羊来。
And you use your hand, 手这边。
用你的手。
You take a spear and pierce him.
拿把刀戳进去。
A spear.
一把刀割戳进去的。
So, the Chinese already prophesied.
中文已经预言了。
God will bring his lamb.
神要赐下他的羊。
And people will take a spear and with their hands pierce him. And you know that happened on Calvary.
而人要拿着刀割戳进他的肋旁，这就在十字架上发生了。
Can you imagine thousands of years before Jesus came?
发现到耶稣来几千年前呢？
Even his death was already prophesied in Chinese writing.
他的死亡都已经在中文文字里面预言出来了。
Now, today,My boy, Dayan, is called Kang Yi.
今天我的儿子的名字就叫康义。
But in Singapore, we write in this simplified format.
可是新加坡我们写的中文是简体字的中文。
But notice, even this word is fantastic.
即使这个简体字都很漂亮啊。
It means the blood.
代表有一滴血。
On the cross.
躺在十字架上。
The blood on the cross.
十字架上的血。
It could mean.The blood in the vessel before God.
它可能是在神面前器皿里的血。
But also mean the blood ultimately they'll be splattered on the cross of Calvary.
可是也代表最终在各个他十字架上流出的血。
So the Chinese unknowingly were expecting.
而华人不知不觉中不断在期待。
Long time ago.
好久好久以前。
Long before Taoism and Confucianism and Buddhism came.
早在道教、佛教、儒教进来之前。
Embedded in their history.
在整个历史当中
But this concept that God will one day send an ultimate Lamb of God that will die on the cross, pierce into the side, and His blood will be a sacrifice for our sin.
有一天，神赐下他的羔羊，死在十字架上，身旁被刺破，让他能够带下他的宝血，拯救我们的罪。
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
So can you imagine?
你可以想象哦。
You grow up writing all these words.
你出去外面写这些字儿。
And unknowingly, you're writing the history of God.Into your heart.
不知不觉把神的历史写在你心里了。
Subconsciously.
潜意识当中。
You are rehearsing the story of the Bible.
你一直重述圣经的故事。
So John 3:16 say, Whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life or eternal life.
在约翰福音三章十六节说，凡信他的不至灭亡，反得永生。
The word eternal life or 永 in the ancient writing is this.
永字的古字是长这样的。
It says, it means when the Lamb comes, He will wash you like water, all your sins away.
这羊来能够像水一样洗净你所有的罪。
Today, we use this word 永 which also means the same thing.
今天我们的字变成这个永字也是同样的意思。
When the blood comes, He will wash you like water.And all your sins will be washed as white as snow. Hallelujah.
当这血流出来，它像水一样洗净你一切污秽的罪。Hallelujah.
You want to clap? Give the Lord a big clap.
我就热烈的拍掌。
How are you saved today?
你今天是怎么得救的？
You are saved through faith.
因着信而得救。
So Romans 10 verse 8 says.
罗马书第十章第八节说。
With the mouth, confession is made unto salvation.
人口里承认就必得救。
So what is faith?
信是什么？
Faith is when a man
是当一个人
uses his mouth to confess.
使用他的嘴说出这个话。
And that confession will bring to faith that will lead to grace that lead to salvation.
而且说的话带出信心，带出得救的救恩来。
Oh, come on, give the Lord a big clap right now.
热烈的拍掌。
Isn't this amazing?
这是不是很神奇?
So you say, wow, never realized this.
你说，哎呦，我都不知道这个嘞。
So the next time somebody tells you,
下一次有人跟你说,
hey, you're Chinese.
哎，你是华人。
Shouldn't you be this, this, this?
你应该做这种教的吗?
You say, no.
你说不。
Long before this, this, this,
早在这些月以前,
we have all this.
我们有这个啦。
They say, oh, you embrace an American faith.
哎呀，你信的是美国人的信仰。
You embrace the faith of George W. Bush or Obama.
哎呀，你信的是布什跟奥巴马的信仰。Or Barack Obama.
You say no.
你说不啊。
You say it's not true.
不是这样啊。
You say it a long time ago.
好久好久以前。
Even as a little boy, a little girl.
即使我是小孩的时候。
As I learned to write all these words.
我就在写这些字儿了。
The story of God.
神的故事。
From Genesis.
从创世纪。
To the flood.
到洪水。
To Babel.
到巴别塔。
To the sacrificial system.
到整个献祭的系统。
To the coming of Christ dying on the cross.
到基督死在十字架上。
To the way I can be blessed.
到我怎么样蒙福。
And what faith is all about.
讲到信心。
God is the God of the Chinese people.
神是华人的神。
I'm going back to my roots.
我要回到我的根源。
I'm going back to my culture.
回到我的文化去。
You want to clap? Give the Lord a big clap.
为主最热烈的拍掌。
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How many of you want to learn even more amazing thing about God in ancient China?
有多少人想学更多神在古代中国要做的事？
You got to come back next week.
下个礼拜回来。
I want to close the night by going to Acts 17.
最后结束，我们要看到《使徒行传》十七章。
Acts 17.
使徒行传十七章。
I know this Chinese New Year, many of you have many stories to tell now.
我知道这个农历年很多人有故事要说了哈。
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In Acts 17 and verse 22.
使徒行传十七章二十一节。
Acts 17 and verse 22.
使徒行传十七章二十二节。
Next week when you come.
下个星期你来。
I'm going to tell you an amazing story.
我跟你讲个非常神奇的故事。
You know, my dad named me after a Chinese emperor.
我爸爸给我取名的时候，就叫一个中国的皇帝取的。
His name is 康熙。
他的名字叫康熙。
康熙皇帝。
清朝的康熙皇帝。
So I asked my dad one day when we were in Taiwan and we were in the Chinese Museum.
啊，有一个我们在台湾故宫博物院的时候，我就问我爸爸了。
I said, and there was a lot of stuff about.康熙
哇，里面很多康熙皇帝的收藏哦。
And one of the things that was on display was that 康熙 was a convert. He was a Christian.
哎，在这个当中哦，看到一段呢，讲到康熙信了主哎。
And how he was praising God.
他怎么样赞美神？他是个基督徒哦。
So next week I'll tell you more about him.
下个星期我给你多讲一点。
The greatest emperor in China, a believer of Jesus Christ.
而中国最伟大的皇帝是相信耶稣基督的信徒。
And I asked my dad, I said, why didn't you name my Why didn't you write my Chinese name exactly like him?
我就问我爸了，你干嘛不让我的名字跟他完全一模一样呢？
He said, if I do that, all your friends will laugh at you.
他说如果我这样，你所有朋友都会笑你啦。
But anyway, next week I'll tell you more about Kangxi, and it's an amazing story.
下个星期我会跟你更多讲一点康熙神奇的故
事。Next week no more writing lessons, okay?
下个星期不要再上这个写字课了哈。
But I tell you a very exciting story.
非常兴奋的故事哦。
But in Acts 17 and verse 22.
实际上十七章二十二节。
Paul came to Athens.
保罗来到雅典。
And Paul did not scold the people for the idolatry.
保罗没有骂这些人拜偶像哎。
He says, "Men of Athens, I perceive that in all things you are very religious."
他说雅典人呐、啊，我看你们凡事很敬畏鬼神。
And then he says in verse 22.
二十二节这里说。
I was passing through and considering the object of your worship.And I've even found an altar with this inscription to the unknown God.
我游行的时候观看你们所敬拜的玉座，一座坛，上面写着未世之神。
Therefore, the one whom you worship without knowing him, I proclaim to you.
你们所不认识而敬拜的，我现在告诉你们。
I tell you, this is our job.
我告诉你，这就是我们的工作。
This is our job in China.
这是我们在中国的工作。
In Taiwan.
在台湾。
Here in Singapore.
在新加坡这里。
And all throughout the Chinese-speaking world.
也到所有华人的世界里头。
Chinese people are like the men of Athens.
华人就好像雅典人一样。
We are very religious.
我们是很有宗教性的。
We are very superstitious.
是很迷信的。
We are scared of ghosts and 鬼 all the time.
哇，一天到晚疑神疑鬼，怕来怕去的。
You know, everything is ghosts here and ghosts there.
哇，这个也是鬼，那个也是鬼的。
You know, 死鬼、洋鬼。
醉鬼、酒鬼、脏鬼。
You know, we are very religious people.
我们都是很敬畏鬼神的。
And what we need to do is point them, because Chinese people are searching for God.
因为华人一直在寻求神。
And we got to tell them the God that you've been searching for.
我们要告诉他你在找的是哪位神。
It's the same God, the first emperor of China worship is the God 上帝。
就是中国人第一个皇帝所敬拜的上帝这个
神。You don't know his name.
你不晓得他的名字。
But to the Hebrew, he is called Yahweh or Jehovah.
但在希伯来人称他为亚伯或耶和华。
To the Christian, he is called Jesus Christ.
对基督徒来说，他叫耶稣基督。
And to the Chinese people from the beginning, he is called 上帝。
而对华人一开头就叫他上帝。
And look at verse 26.
你看二十六节。
And he has made from one blood every nation of men to dwell on all the face of the earth.
他从一本造出万族的人住在全地上。
And has determined the pre-appointed times and the boundaries of habitation.
并且预先定准他们的年限和所住的疆界。
So even while you may not know God,
即使你还不认识神，
God has already included you into His plan to save you.
神已经把你抱在他的计划当中拯救你了。
He wants to reveal himself to you.
他要将他自己显明给你。
He wants to tell you his story.
他想告诉你他的故事。
And tell you your roots and your cultural heritage.
告诉你的根你文化的遗产。
And tell you that he wants to bless you and he has a good plan for you to make you the head and not the tail.
告诉你还要赐福你保护你让你作首不作尾。
To prosper you.
使你富足。
Oh, give the Lord a big hand.
为主热烈的拍掌。
Look at verse 27 now.
你看到二十七节说
So that they should seek the Lord in the hope that they might grope for him and find him, though he is not far from each one of us.
要叫他们寻求神，或者可以揣摩而得，其实他离我们个人不远。
So God is not far.
神不遥远的。
He's just a breath away.
他就像你的呼吸一样。
Do you know the moment you were born? For many of you,
你知道很多的人，你出生的那一刻。
How many of you here are Chinese? Lift up your hand.
有多少在座是华人的，请举手。
How many of you learned to write Chinese as a young boy or girl? Put up your hand.
多少小时候学过中文字的
？As a young child,
你从小。
Even when you write the word 天 a simple word, God was trying to reveal Himself to you.
即使你写天这么简单的字，神都要显明他自己给你看。
I'm the one bigger than all the big on the earth.
我是大过世上一切之上的。
When you write all these words, God is near you, trying to show you.
当你写这些字，神将亲近，想要向你显明。
Come to me, all those that are heavy laden.
那些劳苦担重担到我这里来。
You see, He's orchestrating all the human events.
他在安排所有人类的事件。
Even the bad times, even the economic recession.
即使是逆境，即使经济不景气的时候。
So that every one of us have the greatest chance to know Him and to experience Him and to encounter Him as the true Savior and God of all the earth. Hallelujah.
让每一个人有最好的机会，亲自来遇见、认识、经历，他是我们拯救的神。
Come on, you want to clap, give the Lord a big clap tonight.
为主热烈的拍掌。
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, give the Lord a big hand. Musicians come up right now.
Hallelujah.
How many of you tonight suddenly realize, hey, God really has been trying to show himself to me since I was born? Put up your hands right now.
有多少人觉得我从小神就开始向我显明他自己？
Can we trust him then?
我们可不可以信靠他？
Can we trust him? Who is so interested in us? Can we trust this God, this Heavenly Father, to take care of us when we go through difficult times?
当他这样子关心我们，我们能不能信靠他？在我经历困难的时候，他会继续照顾我。
Of course you can.
当然你可以。
Even this economic recession.
即使在经济不景气的时候。
Can we trust in him?
我们可以信靠他吗？
This God who wants to reveal himself, let me tell you, what does he want to show you? He wants to show you that he's Jehovah Jireh, the God your provider.
他不断想显明他自己，显明什么？他是你耶和华以勒，你的供应者。
He wants to show you that he's El Shaddai, he's the God of more than enough.
他要显明他是伊丽莎的，还是绰绰有余的神。
He wants to show you that when the whole world is going down, you can keep on going up.
他让你看见全世界往下滑，你可以不断往上爬。
Then you say, oh, but how? You know, I've been retrenched.
你说怎么办？怎么办？我已经失业了。
Every problem is a new opportunity.
每一个问题都可能是新的机会。
For God to explode His blessings into your life.
因为神将他的福分浇在你生命里。
For you to discover new talents that will take you into the next realm.
让你能够发挥新的才华，进入更高的领域。
Tonight, I want you to begin to pray.
今晚我要你开始祷告。
God, I want to trust you to take care of me.
神，我信靠你能照顾我。
Well, how many of you also secondly tonight?
而第二，有多少人在我们当中？
You can suddenly you believe and you have faith. Man, if God is the God of the Chinese people, then my family can get saved.
你有信心，神是华人的神，我的家人都可以得救的。
My grandparents, my father, my mother, my brother, my sister.
我的祖父母、爸爸妈妈、兄弟姐妹。
Long before these things came in, He is the God of China.
早在这些进来之前，他就是中国人的神呢。
Now you realize why the greatest revival is happening in China right now.
所以你了解为什么最大的复兴现在在中国发生？
Because inbuilt in the Chinese culture.
因为在华人文化里面内造的。
Is this hunger for this one true God?
就是要渴慕这位真实的神。
So that is why when you talk to Chinese people.
所以每一次你跟华人说话。
You don't need to get into deep theology.
你不需要进到很深的神学。
You don't need to explain like if you got to talk to you know, other parts of the world.
你不用跟好像外星人要去解释很多东西。
Simply tell the Chinese.
你只要跟他谈中文。
He's your God.
他是你的神啊。
He loves you.
他爱你。
He wants to bless you.
他要赐福你。
And everywhere you go in the Chinese world, they open their hearts and say, I want to be a believer.
华人世界每一个角落当中一谈，他就敞开心，愿意介绍他做救
主。Because this is like going back to our roots.
因为这是回到我们的根
据。This is going back to our real culture.
回到真正的文化。
Tonight, let's all stand up on our feet right now.
让我们一起站立起来。
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let's just lift our hands and just begin to worship this great God.